Welcome back. We started the discussion of distributed systems with definitions and principles. We then saw how object technology, with its innate concepts of inheritance and reuse, helps in structuring distributed services at different levels. In this next lesson module, we will discuss the design and implementation of some select distributed system services. Technological innovation comes when one looks beyond the obvious and immediate horizon. Often, this happens in academia because academicians are not bound by market pressures or compliance to existing product lines. You'll see this out-of-the-box thinking in the three subsystems that we're going to discuss as part of this lesson module. Another important point, often the byproducts of a thought experiment may have more lasting impact than the original vision behind the thought experiment. History is ripe with many examples. We will not have the ubiquitous yellow sticky note, but for space exploration. Now, close to home for this course, Java would not have happened but for the failed video on demand trials of the 90s. In this sense, the services we're going to discuss as part of this lesson module, while interesting in their own right, may themselves be not as important as the technological insights they offer on how to construct complex distributed services. Such technological insights are the reusable products of most thought experiments. There's a common theme in the three distributed subsystems we're going to discuss. Memory is a critical, precious resource. With advances in network technology, leveraging the idle memory of a peer in a local area network may help overcome shortage of memory locally available in a particular node. The question is how best to use the cluster memory, that is, the physical memory of peers tend to be idle at any particular point of time in a local area network. The global memory system, GMS, asks the question, how can we use the peer memory for paging across the local area network? And later on, we will see DSM, which stands for Distributed Shared Memory, asks the question, if shared memory makes the life of application programmers simple in a multiprocessor, can we try to provide the same abstraction in a cluster and make the cluster appear like a shared memory machine? And the third work that we will see is distributed file system, in which we ask the question, can we use the cluster memory for cooperative caching of files? Anyhow, back to our first part of this three-part lesson module, namely the global memory system.